I'm going to start real numbers, first chapter of class 10 CBSE, real numbers. So first, what are real numbers? Real numbers are the combination of rational numbers as well as irrational numbers. So what are rational numbers? The numbers which we can represent in P by Q form, where Q is not equal to 0. If Q becomes 0, so this number is not defined. We call it as not defined. Again, what are irrational numbers? Irrational numbers. These numbers can't represent in the form of P by Q. We can't represent as these are non-recurring. These are non-recurring and non-terminating numbers. Non-terminating numbers. Non-recurring means it will not recur. Like value of pi is 3.14. Keep on going. This will not terminate also. This will not terminate. This is not going to end. Non-recurring means 2.14. This will recur. Means 1 4 1 4 1 4. This is not a rational number. So 1 4 something keep on going. There is non-recurring. This will not repeat again and again. And this will not terminate also. One more example if I take. Like 10 100 1000 140. This also is not going to terminate anywhere. So these numbers are known as irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. So real numbers are the combination of rational numbers as well as irrational numbers. You might be wondering about what are imaginary numbers. That is not your syllabus, but which can imaginary numbers are root. If we are writing root anything minus 2 or something like that, so these numbers are known as imaginary numbers. Imaginary numbers. So real numbers are consisting of rational numbers as well as irrational numbers, while imaginary numbers are, if we write in root, if we write negative number, then we call it as imaginary numbers. So these are the brief introduction about real numbers. Now I'm going to the next topic of the same chapter, that is Euclid's division lemma. So what is Euclid's division lemma? So we have to not learn any formulas as such, but from childhood, we are keep on learning that, learning division part, right? Suppose I'm writing 2 divided by 19. So if you divide this 19 by 2, we'll get here 2 9s are 18, 1. So we can write here 19 is equals to what we can write here? 2 into 9 plus 1. Okay. Again, this 1. We can write this 2 down. Again, we can write here 2, 2, 0. We have to keep on doing here till the 0 comes down. Okay. So for 2, what we can write? 2 is equals to 1 into 2 plus 0. So this is nothing but Euclid's division lemma. We call it as Euclid's division lemma. Lemma. L-E-M-M-A. So this is nothing but we can write here it as 19 is equals to 2 into 9 plus 1. So what is 19 here? 19 is nothing but dividend. Dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This is nothing but Euclid's division lemma. Or we can write in other words as dividend, we are just representing it as A. A is equals to BQ plus R. A is equals to BQ plus R, where this where this remainder R should be greater than equal to zero. R should be greater than equal to zero and less than B. That is, remainder should be greater than equal to zero and less than B. B is what? B is nothing but divisor. You can check it here. If you check here, remainder, what is remainder here? 1. Okay, remainder is 1. So this is greater than or equal to 0. This is greater than equal to 0. This is greater than 0. And lesser than B. What is B over here? B is nothing but divisor. Divisor is 2. So this is less than 2. So remainder should always be, remainder should always be greater than equal to 0 or less than B. So this is nothing but Euclid's division lemma. So there is, now you are wondering about what is Euclid's division algorithm. Algorithm is nothing but steps to solve question. Okay. Steps to solve question. How we are going to solve? How we are finding HCF? The step of solving, see, these, we are finding the HCF of 225 and 867. So these are the steps to find HCF. Steps to find HCF. So this is nothing but, we call it as Euclid's division algorithm. Euclid's division algorithm. Euclid's division algorithm. Next, how to find HCF by the help of Euclid's division theorem? We are going to discuss one example for this. Okay, we are just going to do one example for this. That is, suppose HCF of 225 and 867, or you can take the first example here. That is 135 and 225. 135 and 225. We have to find HCF of 135 and 225. First of all, we have to divide like normal division. 135, 225. So 1s are 35, 1s are 135. This is 90, 135. You have to keep on dividing till we get 0 in the last. 90 ones are 90. Again, 45 and 90. 45 twos are 90. So we have got 0. So by Euclid's division, by Euclid's division algorithm, we can write it as, that is, A is equals to BQ plus R. A, B, R, Q, everything you know. So A is equals to, we can write 225 is equals to 135 into 1 plus 90. Again, we can write 135 is equals to 90 into 1 plus 45. Again, we can write 90 is equals to 45 into 2 plus 0. Here we need to stop. We got 0, so we have to stop till here. Again, what is your HCF? So B is the HCF of the last. B of last step is HCF. So HCF is equals to 45. In this way, we can find HCF by the help of Euclid's division algorithm or Euclid's division lemma. Hope you understand everything. Now moving to the next questions. Moving to the next question, we are having question number two, NCERT question number two. Question number one is all of you can do this question number one. And I'm going to do question number second. So that any positive odd integer is in the form of 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, and 6q plus 5. Any positive odd integer, we can think odd integers as 1, 3, 5, 7 dash dash dash. Okay. So this is the form of 6q plus 1 or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. If you divide here 6 and if you divide 1 here, so what you get? 6 zeros are 0, you get here 1. So which form is this 6q plus 1 form? What is 6? 6 as it is, you write. What is quotient? 0 plus 1. So this is nothing but 1 itself. See, anything if you're going to divide with 6, you'll get in this form itself, 6q plus 1. But in generally in class 10th, we are writing in other form, like the thing is we are writing here a is equals to bq plus r. So in this case, your b is equals to 6. What is coming here? 6q, 6q, 6q. You write b as 6. And r should be greater than or equal to 0 and less than 6. That is b. So r is equals to what we can write? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we have to put the value of b and r in equation first. Putting the value of b and r. Putting the value of b and r in equation first. We get what we get first. B is equals to 6, r is equals to 0, r is equals to 1, r is equals to 2, r is equals to 3, r is equals to 4, and r is equals to 5. We have to go till here. See, if b is equals to 6 and r is equals to 0, what we get? A is equals to, we get 6q. That's it. Again, r is equals to 1, then a is equals to 6q plus 1, 6q plus 2, 6q plus 3, 6q plus 4, 6q plus 5. So here, odd integers, these are the odd integers, r is equals to 1, r is equals to 1, r is equals to 3, r is equals to 5. So these are the odd integers. For odd integers, we'll get in the form of 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, and 6q plus 5. So for odd integers, we'll get in this form itself. Now, next question, question number third. Question number third is an army contingent of 660 members. An army contingent of 660 members is to march behind the army band of 32 members in a parade. The two groups are to march in the same number of columns. What is the maximum number of columns in which they can march? So there are two groups, like first one is army group and second one is members, right? So army are having some number of columns here. The number of columns should be same for army as well as members. So let the number of columns be X. Let the column, this is X columns, in which army as well as members are standing. Again here, number of rows of army are let it as Y, and number of rows of members are let it as Z. So number of columns should remain the same for both army as well as members. So here we have to find as what is the maximum number of column which they can march. Maximum number of column we should find. Means we have to find X here. So for army, what we can write here? X into y, total number of column multiply by total number of rows, that is x into y. Again, total number of members, we can write it as x into z. And we have to find x. It means that we have to find HCF, that is highest common factor. Highest common factor of 32 and 616. If you find HCF, how you find before, you will get the answer as 8. So 8 is the maximum number of column which they can match. Hope it's clear. Now next question is question number 4. Again by Euclid's division lemma, we have to show that square of any positive integer are in the form of 3m, 3m plus 1, and 3m plus, only 3m and 3m plus 1, I think, yes, 3m and 3m plus 1. So again we have to use division algorithm, right? So division algorithm is A is equals to BQ plus R. A is equals to BQ plus R. See here, B is equals to what we can write here. See here, 3 is there. They can write here 3. Then R is equals to greater than equal to 0 and less than equal to 3. That's it. Now put the value of B and 3. B and R. B is equal to 3 and R is equals to 0. R is equals to 1. R is equals to 2. What we get the answer? A is equals to 3q. A is equals to 3q plus 1. A is equal to 3q plus 2. But here any positive integer, square of any positive integer either of 3m or 3m plus 1. Now we have to square. They are saying the square of it. Now we have to squaring both sides. What we get is try to understand. So a square is equals to 3q square. So we can write here it as, 3q whole square. So 9q whole square, we can write it as 3 multiplied by 3q square. So this is nothing but any integer, m. 3m we can write, we can denote this 9q square as 3m form. 3q square can be written as m, any this is m is any integer. So 3m we can write in. For the second case, see, r is equals to 1. So we can write here a square is equals to 3q plus 1 whole square. So we can write it as 9q square plus 1 plus 3 to the 6q. Again, we have to try to form of 3m plus 1. We have to bring it to 3m plus 1 form. The plus 1 you try to make it at the last. And 9q square plus 6q. Again, 9q square plus 6q, you can write in 3q square plus 2q form. So again, this is any integer, you can write m. So we can write this form as 3m plus 1. The first part we are getting in 3m form. Second part we are getting in 3m plus 1. Now check the last one. That is r is for r is equals to 2. So we are getting it as a square is equals to 3q plus 2 whole square. So we get it as 3, 3 is a 9q square plus 4 plus 3 to a 6 to the 12q. Again, we have to get 3m plus 1. So take from 1 from outside from here. From 4, you take 1. So what we can write? 9q square plus 3 plus 4q. Again, we can take 3 common. 3q square plus 1 plus here is 12q, 4q plus 1. Then again, this part can be written as m form. So this is also a form of 3m plus 1. That's the answer. That's the proof of this question. Hope it's clear to everyone. So next question, that is last question of exercise 1.1. That is any use Euclid's division lemma. Use Euclid's division lemma. Show that Q of any positive integer is in form of 9m, 9m plus 1, 9m plus 8. So remember that here r is equal, b is a is equals to bq plus r. So here q is equals to, sorry, b is equals to 9, and r should be greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 9. So here you have to find, here they are asking cube of it. So here r value is 0, 1, 2 till 8, right? So if you're going to put the values and all, you'll get like a is equals to 9q, and then 9q plus 1, 9q plus 2, and so on. Again, you are going to cube this. If you are going to cube this, you'll get a long, long answer. You have to go for 8 steps, you should go down. Okay. So better than this, you can consider it as 3 itself. B is equals to 3. Okay. You can consider B is equals to 3. That is much easier to get 9m, because 9 is a multiple of 3 also. You can try by 3. Okay. So B is equals to 3. If you take, your steps are been saved. This is much more easier. R is equals to, you should try only for 0, 1, and 2. So if you take R is equals to 0, you'll get 3q. A is equal to 3q. A is equal to 3q plus 1. If R is equals to 1, 3q plus 1. If R is equals to 2, then you get A is equal to 3q plus 2. On cubing both sides, what we get on cubing both sides, we can write here for R is equals to 0. You can write here a cube is equals to 3 cube whole cube. That is your 927 q to the power 3. We can write it as 9 common. 9 threes are 27 whole cube. So this is in form of 9n. It is given over here. Next one is r is equals to 1. For r is equals to 1, just write them down. R is equals to 1. We can write here a cube is equals to 3 cube plus 1 to the power 4 cube. Now all of us know the formula, a cube, that is 27 q to the power 3 plus b cube plus 3 a square b plus 3 a b square. A b square. We can get 27 q whole cube plus 1 plus 3 is 927. U square plus 3 is a 9, 9q. So we have to get in 9m plus 1 form. So 1 you can take it outside, plus 1, and write 27q whole cube plus 27q square plus 9q. We can take 9 common from this. 9 3 is a 27, q plus 3q square plus 3q plus 1. Again, we can write this as m. So this is a form of 3 9m plus 1. Similarly, we can do it for r is equals to 2 also. So that's the whole exercise, I think. That's the completion of whole exercise of division lemma. Okay. So we're just trying to stop the video like here itself. Thank you.